I'm Vignesh Ishwan. I'll be speaking about motivic analysis and its relevance to raga identity in Carnatic music. This is basically the outline of my talk. I'll be introducing the topic by saying why do we need motivic analysis in Carnatic music. The database that I've mined, the phrases that I've marked, we have marked, and the motif identification done, the methods used, and etc. The goal of this task that we are doing is based on the basis of Carnatic music. In Carnatic music, we cannot decompose the elements of swaras and gamakas as said by T.M. Krishna yesterday. All of these have to be taken in congruence. They have to be taken together and seen as a single identity. So we have taken up phrases of different ragas, and we want to see whether the machine learning algorithms can pick up the invariants within them and can recognize these phrases. For doing this, we have mined a database of 1 terabyte of Carnatic music. We have monitored through occurrences of 35 ragas in the database, and we've seen that ragas that occur the most in this database are Todi, Kalyani, Kamboji, Bhairavi, Shankarabharanam, Varali, and Karaharapriya also, which we have not added. These are mainly the big six in Carnatic music also, since they are chosen for elaboration, for elongated elaborations. Now, ragas across various artists, male, female, and instrumental, were also chosen for analysis. We excluded Todi from our analysis since it's a really complex raga and it is viable for analysis in itself, in totality. And another constraint that we have put on ourselves is that we have used the alapana section of each and every recording, because the pitch contours are really bad due to presence of percussion in the song pieces. So how did I go about marking phrases? Initially, I started marking the gamakas of each and the gamakas that are present in each and every phrase. It turned out to be really cumbersome, because as you can see, a phrase contains so many gamakas interlaced within them. This phrase, for example, contains 3 gamakas. This is a phrase of the raga Bhairavi which contains 3 gamakas in them. I have not marked the other ones that are present because the boundaries are not specific for them. So what we realized is we cannot take gamakas as a single identity. We need to take the phrase as a single identity, the entire phrase of that raga. So what we did about is started marking the characteristic phrases of these ragas. Each raga has many characteristic phrases. So I started marking with the raga for the raga Kamboji and went on for marking for the other ragas. Initially, when I marked all the phrases that I thought were important for Kamboji, Bhairavi, and Shankarabharanam Varali, and Kalyani. As you can see, I've marked 10 phrases, 9:30 for each of these ragas. I got many instances for a lot of phrases, but the number of occurrences for some phrases were really meager. For machine learning algorithms, it's really important to have a large number of occurrences of one single phrase, of a type of phrase. So I narrowed down my search to the phrases which are occurring a lot of times in a certain alapana section. So I found out that these phrases that I have mentioned over here had so many occurrences, and I started looking for these phrases alone and marking them. The analysis was performed on these phrases. Now, our lookout or our perspective on a motif is that motifs can be thought of as signature prosodic phrases. Prosody in this context means the increase in duration of notes, usage of appropriate intonation patterns by employing gamakas and modulating energy. So it's pitch, duration, and energy. So we think that motif can be called as a prosodic phrasing of a sequence of notes. These are the different phrases that I had marked for the different ragas. I can play them from here. Yeah. So the first phrase is the phrase for the raga Bhairavi. Oh. I'm not getting any volume. It's not on mute.
You sure?
Yeah.
Pick it up and then play it.
Yeah, okay.
No, play it. We should hear it from your computer.
I have to see it there since there's a displacement.
Okay. Which one? This one? Okay.
All right. One second, I'll just have to tweak this a bit. That is the first phrase for Bhairavi. So as you can see, the phrase lies, it's the first part of the entire phrase that I've sung. So what I have marked, it's in red, is tadarella rigama badapa. Now the next phrase that I've marked for Bhairavi is. So as you can see, that lies in between of whatever I've sung, the entire part of the phrase that I've sung. So over there, the third one is for Shankarabharanam. The next one is again for Shankarabharanam. Again for Shankarabharanam. That's for Bhairavi and Shankarabharanam. These are the phrases that I had marked for Kamboji, Kalyani and Varali. Another one. Now, just pardon the change in tonic for Kalyani. So I recorded these in isolation. So this is the phrase for the raga Varali. So these are the different types of phrases. We took 10 types of phrases across these 5 ragas that we have chosen for analysis. Now what we thought, we tried to recognize these phrases, we tried to do a DTW. As you can see, DTW gives almost accurate results for continuous feature vectors. Like you can see your pitch contours for the reference and query are pretty similar and continuous. So the warping is it's pretty nice. You can see that the overlap is really nice, and very little parts of the reference can be seen, and the overlap between the reference and query is really nice. Now these phrases can be sung by different musicians with substantial difference in their way of singing. So the same phrase can be sung in different context at different speeds with different durations or whatever. So the pitch contours can be really dissimilar, and this can result in really bad distance measures for DTW. As you can see over here, the reference of the query, these are the same phrases but they look pretty different, and as you can see, the overlap is not very good. A lot of the reference is seen and very less of the query is also overlapping on it, and it's not really good. So DTW fails over here. And so what we thought was, we could do we could use hidden Markov models for recognizing these phrases. We used the left-right HMM model for music. All of this is spoken in detail by Hema ma'am in her in the internal meeting that we had. Now over here, the A's correspond to the probabilities of state transitions, and B's correspond to the output probabilities of the states. We have this is a 4-state model. Now how we went about is, we started building models for each of the phrases. So for each kind of phrases, we had marked a large number of examples. We gave in all these, we built models for all these examples by pumping in a lot of examples for each of the kind of phrases, and we built a model database, you can say. So for training these, what we did was, we give a music signal of the phrase. We extract the feature, that is the pitch contour. We test this pitch contour with the models that we have, the HMM models that we have. And the one that gives the maximum likelihood of a certain phrase is recognized at that phrase. This is what happens. Now, so what we did after this was, we did a forced alignment on the recognized phrases. This is a phrase of the raga Kamboji, you can see. And the HMM has figured out the states on its own. And the beautiful part over here is, it has recognized in itself, recognized in itself the underlying invariant in these notes. You can see in these phrases. You can see the state 11 in the first phrase. This is like a flat and an upward movement. The state 11 in all the other phrases again is a flat upward movement, flat and an upward movement, flat and an upward movement. This thing. So this has been figured out by the machine in itself. You can see the state number 2 also. This is account. You can also see that this is accounted for the difference in duration of these sub phrases that we have in these phrases. In the first example, the first part of the phrase is pretty long. But the same state number, state 2, even though the first part of the phrase is short and it is flat, has been assigned by the machine itself. So this is really exciting and interesting for us. So this is why we thought HMMs can be really appropriate for recognizing phrases. The results we got were also pretty interesting with respect to the errors that we observed also. A total of 10 motifs as seen were experimented on, 2 motifs for Bhairavi, 3 motifs for Shankarabharanam, 3 motifs for Kamboji, 1 motif for Kalyani and a motif for Varali. Why I chose Varali was that I wanted to see that Varali has an occurrence of a single phrase, Tala, many times, even though the raga is not sung as much as seen in the database. So I chose Varali so just to see a raga that is outside the big 6. The table below gives the confusion matrix for the results observed. As you can see, we have chosen two different phrases for a single raga. Even then, the machine distinguishes between those two phrases even though they lie in the same raga. As you can see, Bhairavi 1, most of the phrases of the Bhairavi phrase 1 have been classified into the phrase Bhairavi phrase 1. Most of the phrases of Bhairavi phrase 2, examples of Bhairavi phrase 2 have been classified in Bhairavi phrase 2. And accordingly for Kamboji and Varali. The only confusion that we are observing is between Kalyani and Shankarabharanam because the ragas are pretty similar. And 2 phrases of Shankarabharanam, the first phrase and the third phrase of Shankarabharanam, as you can see, it's 29 and 10. It's getting confused because the nature of the phrase is pretty similar. Also, we didn't realize the duration of the phrase and the way it is intoned and all at the beginning when I was marking. So that's why it's getting confused. So the confusion, there is an order even in the confusion that's happening over here. So that's pretty interesting and we can work on it later on. So now the next thing that we want to do and has a future research for this task that we've taken up is phrase spotting. So like J-Rose and all in their work, they have spotted the motifs in a bandish by using percussive cues in from the tabla. Now in Carnatic music, in these alapana sections, we do not have percussive cues. So the task would be to look for these phrases in chunks of these alapanas. We cannot just search for a needle in a haystack. An entire alapana is of 10 minutes or so, and we cannot look for a phrase in an entire 10 minute alap. These phrases would lie in an intonation unit or a breath group, since we as human beings take breaths while singing. So this is the probable method that we can apply for searching for phrases in an alapana. So the next task would be to split these alapanas into intonation units or breath groups and look for the phrases in them. Thank you, that's all. These are the references.